Welcome everyone. In this video lecture, we will solve a very simple gate question in which we have to find the drain current equation. Drain current. Okay. So in this particular question, it is given the gate to source voltage of a MOSFET with threshold voltage 400 millivolt. So threshold voltage is given 400 millivolt, and the corresponding MOSFET is operating in the saturation region. And its value is 900 millivolt. So the VGS value is given 900 millivolt. And the observed current, that is our drain current, is 1 milliampere. So we have to use the first concept to find out the value of transconductance, because there is no transconductance term is given. And if we neglect the channel width modulation, and assuming the MOSFET in the saturation region, we have to find the value of drain current for the VGS 1400 millivolt. So in this question, the threshold voltage will be constant. Okay. So the given thing, for the first line, we can say, the very first VT is given 400 millivolt, or one can write simply 0.4 volt. Okay, 400 into 10 to the minus 3, so we can write it 0.4 volt. For the gate to source voltage is given 900 millivolt, that is our simply 0.9 volt. And it gives a current ID, how much? 1 milliampere. Okay, so the first thing is given. Okay, in the next line, or in the next slide, I am writing VT will be same for the other one also, 0.4 volt. Okay, and the corresponding VGS is given 1400 millivolt, or we can write as 1.4 volt. Okay, so we have to find the value of ID. Okay, and in this question, both are operating in the saturation region. So this one is a very simple question. Okay, so what next we have to do? From the first side, okay, first we have to write the drain current equation, and in the first one we can find the value of transconductance, because in this one also we have to know the value of Kn, which is unknown to us. Okay, so from these three known quantity we can find Kn. So what is the drain current equation in saturation region? Saturation, very well known formula we have to use, mu n cox w by l whole divided by 2 vgs minus vt whole square. This is the only calculation based numerical. So, or one can write this whole term h k. Okay, vgs, or we can write h k. Okay, and this ID saturation, for the time being I am writing this one is simply ID. So this, now we can put the value of ID here. So it should be 1 milliampere, Kn as it is, okay, VGS here 0.9 minus 0.4 whole square, or in bracket I am writing for the unit volt square. Okay, so Kn value will be 1 milliampere whole divided by 0.9 minus 0.4 whole square. It means it should be 0.5 whole square, and it should be better to write the unit also. Okay. So it should be 1 k, right? 1 milli by 0.5 into 0.5. Okay. Ampere by volt square. One can remove this decimal. Is it okay? Okay. So now, so it should be 4 excuse me, 4 milliampere per volt square. So this can value is now known to us, 4 milliampere volt square. Okay, so now next, in the next part we have to think about this one. Now Kn value is now known to us, that is about 4 milliampere per volt square from say equation number 1. So now we have to find the value of Id. So everything is here. So we have to find the value of Id. So one can write simply Kn VGS minus VT. VT will be same here. So what we have to write? Kn 4 milli. I am just writing milli. Okay, VGS 1.4. So better to write 1.4 minus VT 0.4 whole square. Okay, so it should be meter ampere per volt square, ampere per volt square into volt square. I am writing here. This should be milliampere then. So it should be 4 into 1.4 minus 0.14. So it should be 1 square. So it should be 4 ampere. So the Id value will be simply our 4 milliampere. So this one is the very simple question. Okay, so one can say the answer for this question will be 4 milliampere. 4 milliampere is the right option. Okay, so basically in this question, VT and VGS is given and ID value is given. So we have to find the value of Kn. So we have already found the value of Kn, 4 milliampere per volt square. Threshold voltage will be constant in both the cases. Okay, only they have changed the VGS. Okay, and Kn we have calculated from the earlier one, earlier data, VT, VGS, VID. And by using simple gradient equation, we can find the value of ID. So the our correct answer will be 4 milliampere. So this one is all about this simple question. So we have to also practice some simple question because it will boost up our confidence. So this is all about this simple GATE 2003 question. So thank you for watching.